Namaste, my dear students. In today's class, we are going to start with the basic concepts of geometry. So, first you have to understand this that geometry is nothing but a branch of mathematics that was basically meant for measuring earth. The word geometry comes from two words, geo and metron. Geo meaning earth and metron meaning measurement. So from this it is very clear that geometry was basically a branch of mathematics that was used to measure the size of the earth, the measurements of the earth. And we Indians were very ahead of the other people when it comes to geometry, because we had the Sulva Sutras which had actually given us the idea of constructing triangles, constructing the squares and rectangles. This is because the Indians used to perform many pujas and homas, wherein they used to construct the homa kundas according to the required measurement. So when the other people of the world or the other people, they didn't even know about lines and ray segments and all that, we already knew how to construct squares and rectangles. You can now imagine and appreciate how Indians were very well advanced in the field of geometry. However, after a few centuries, I can say it was Euclid who was honored as the father of geometry, because till then there was no person who had actually defined many undefinable elements that existed in geometry. It was Euclid who for the first time gave some solid definitions for the concepts like points, lines, angles, planes and so on. Till then nobody had tried to define it under some set of words, which Euclid did, and that's how he is rightly called as the father of geometry. Euclid was basically a Greek mathematician and he has written a book called as Elements. In his book called as Elements, he mentions about point, line, ray, segment and many other entities that would exist in geometry. Now today we are going to learn about some basic entities that would exist in geometry, the knowledge of which is very essential for us to move on with the remaining part of the syllabus. So the very basic entity that we often discuss in geometry is the point. There is no geometry without the word point as point, I can say. So you can see here that the point is nothing but a dimensionless entity, that is, it doesn't have length, it doesn't have breadth, or it doesn't have any magnitude. So it's a dimensionless quantity or it's a dimensionless entity which is created by an impression made by any sharp or pointed object. You can see here that this is the pen of the smart board. It has a tip which is pointed. So with this, if I create an impression on the board here, the moment I create an impression on the board with this pointed object, it becomes a point. So this is called as a point. And when it comes to a point, you should know this that the position of each point is unique in a plane. Say for example, if I consider this board as a plane, now you know that this board is made up of many such points. You can see here about that. So this, when I consider one point as such, this is a different point. With respect to the position of this point, it is quite different from the position of this point on the plane. And this position is different from this position of the point. Even though they lie on the same plane or they lie along the same line, the position of each point is unique on a plane. So, coming to the next entity, it is the plane. So, what is a plane here is, according to Euclid, any flat surface can be called as a plane. That's how we use the word plane surface also. So it is nothing but a flat or an even surface which is made up of infinite number of points. Say for example, I consider this board as a plane. You can see this board is made up of so many points like this. This is one point, this is one point. When I start plotting a point along a line or along a direction, you can see that infinite number of points can be found on this plane. So a plane is a flat surface. made up of infinite number of points. So that is a plane. Now coming to the next important entity in geometry, we are going to discuss about what is called as a ray. Okay? So this ray is basically a geometric entity that is obtained by joining, see here, I am joining points like this. So you got a line as such. Now when this line can be extended only along one direction, when I cannot extend this point along both the directions, it is only along one direction, I actually call it as a ray. So a ray is always represented by a line with an arrow head like this. So this is a ray and it is named using the capital alphabets in English. So now coming to the next concept here. The next concept here which I will be discussing is the segment. So what is a segment or a line segment as we commonly call it here is, a segment is nothing but a part of a straight line. So whenever I talk about this part of a straight line, say suppose this is a line, this part becomes a line segment. You can see here that PQ is a line here and a part of it becomes a line segment. So it can be, it cannot be extended on both the directions because its magnitude is fixed as such. It is just a part of the line. So a line can be extended along both the directions, you can see here, and any part of the line can be called as a line segment. So the magnitude of the line segment is fixed and that is how you cannot extend it on both the directions. Say for example, when I say construct a line segment of 5 cm, I take the exact measurement as 5 cm only. So I cannot change the measurement of this line segment. That is how the line segment's measurement is always fixed. Now coming to the next entity called as line. So a set of points which can be extended along both the directions. Here you can see here that in the case of a line, it can be extended on both the directions as according to our will and wish, and any such geometric entity is called as a line. Again, whenever we talk about line as a geometric entity, we also talk about straight line, wherein whenever on a plane, when I join a set of points along a fixed direction, I get what is called as a straight line. Along a fixed direction, I should have a direction which is a fixed one. So this is a straight line, and now this is a straight line, this is also a straight line. So this is also a straight line. The directions are all fixed here along these lines. So it is a straight line. Now coming to one more geometric entity which is called as a curved line as such. You can see here these are all curved lines. So there is no fixed direction for us to join the points here along all the directions or along any direction. In a haphazard manner we can actually join the points which will give us a curved line. So this is about the basic concepts or basic entities that we are going to study in geometry, and in the subsequent classes you will also be studying about various other concepts in geometry. Now I want you all to take down the assignment questions and write the answers for these assignment questions. The first assignment question would be, name 4 basic geometric entities. Any 4 basic geometric entities you have to name. The second one is, what is a point? So what do you mean by the geometric entity point? That is the second question. Now the third question is, name the geometric entity obtained when a set of points are joined along only one direction. Only one direction. Next, a set of points are joined along different directions unevenly. Set of points are joined along different directions unevenly. Then, The next question is, who is the father of geometry? Who is the father of geometry? It's the last.